Awkward.
Okay. Hello. This is my Q&A video, as promised. Okay, so I was looking through Twitter recently, and someone simply said, I miss Rachel Rambles, and if you can't think of anything, do a Q&A from your fans. And I thought, what the hell, why not? That's a great idea. I've done it before, I'll do it again, and so that's what I'm gonna do. Okay, so the questions begin now.
What have you been doing lately, and how have you been?
I've been good. I've been in LA, as a lot of you guys know, it's been over a year. Got myself an agent and done a few things here and there. I guess I've been a little quiet, just making some decisions and living my life and figuring things out. But yeah, for the most part, I've been really, really good.
Would you do Rachel Rambles on Periscope?
Yeah. I actually went, I looked up what Periscope was because I didn't know, and it looked amazing. It looks like exactly what I'm doing, except I don't have to go through the middleman of using my camera and uploading it onto YouTube and all that kind of stuff. I could just do a Q&A super fast. I think that's how it works. So I'm going to look into that, and I don't see why not. I think that's awesome. So yeah. Yes.
Did you actually say things when you played Rita Repulsa?
No. No. Because then he would have had to dub over my voice as opposed to just add his in. But I mean, that wasn't really thought through. I just was kind of like, he asked me like, can you do this voice? And I was like, I mean, I can, but he was like, you know, I was kind of like, I could try, but he was already trying to show me how to do it. And it was just kind of like, why doesn't he just do it? I think, I don't remember who thought of it or whatever, but we were all just like, I'm just gonna move my mouth around. And then that gave me more freedom to do different things. Like, I wasn't thinking about what I was saying or anything. So, it's a weird thing to be just like yelling and moving your mouth around. So I kind of just got crazier and crazier, and I think the character called for it anyways. So yeah, that's what happened. I know it's funny because I never really put that much thought into this character, you know, not that I don't put thought into it and shouldn't try and stuff, but you know, again, I don't have like weeks and weeks to go over who this character is. We just show up, make it work, and I think of something that's crazy that something stick and some things just don't, so. But yeah, that was a tangent. No, I didn't do the voice at all, if that's all done.
Work-related or not, what has been some of the best things you've done in LA so far?
The best things? I filmed a commercial. That was really fun. It was like, it was a whole new experience because, I mean, I had done extra work on commercials before, but being in it and being a part of it was just so fun, and being in a, you know, just being in LA and doing the LA thing. What was the question again? What have I been doing?
What has been some of the best things you've done in LA so far?
Right. Unrelated to work things too, I'm assuming. So it's been nice to reconnect with a lot of my old friends and a lot of my family, because again, I'm from California, so just having that support system around me has made life just so nice. I was going really fast and really strong there for a while, especially in Chicago, and it's really important to kind of slow down and go back to your bearings and really remember who helped you get where you are, and never forget them. So I've been spending a lot of time with people that I love, and that's been a great thing about LA. And it's always sunny. Next!
What is your favorite movie?
Everybody asks me that. And every time I say, I don't know, and don't be mad, I don't really watch movies. Like, I mean, I do, but I always say Lord of the Rings is some of my favorite movies, because it is, but I feel like I give the same answer every single time. So. The reason I love that movie series, though, is because I like the, I don't know, I feel like in my past life I was like some type of elf warrior or something, because for some reason that whole genre just speaks to me. I really like it, and whenever it's anything but that type of genre, I don't get as lost in it. I'm more aware that it's a movie, which is good sometimes too, but I don't know, I don't, I don't, like to create my own stories and things in my head than always watching somebody else's creation. Coffee.
How did you get into acting?
I used to perform all the time as a singer, and I've always been really passionate about that, being on stage and all that kind of thing. But I was always kind of embarrassed. I was embarrassed to sing in front of people unless it was like a show with a stage. But when I was just very shy, but I always loved to sing, so there was a part of me who always wanted to be in the spotlight, but it was very conflicting. And then I was doing school choir, and then there was a musical. I don't know, it's a hard one to ask. I guess I've done shows throughout my life, but it was never truly acting until I became serious about it when I started, I guess, in my senior year of high school. They found me in the choir, they were looking for singers, and I said I'd do it, and I just had a blast. And it was that simple. You know, I wasn't like, I'm going to be an actor for the rest of my life. It just kind of, things unfolded, and then I found myself accepted into this great school, and then I just kept going. College was never for me. Things like that were never for me, so this is a great way to live the lifestyle I want to live and get to feel creative every single day.
What's your favorite book series?
Is it dumb to say? Lord of the Rings again, one of my favorite book series, because that was embarrassing. Okay, but that's specific because it's a series. So I've never read the Harry Potter books. Everyone's gonna freak out about that one because I know it is. Again, I'm like, there is the genre you like, and I'm like, yeah, you know, yeah, kinda. I tried starting the Game of Thrones series, and I got through the first book close to it, and then I just never kept going because I mean, I was so enthralled with watching the series, so I was like. I'm not going to read the books right now. Book series, yeah, that's... I'm looking at my bookshelves right here. I'm just trying to, like... Lord of the Rings. I like Dan Brown books. I think they're interesting. I think they make you think, make you question. I don't know. Yeah, that's my answer.
What do you do that helps you get through hard times?
What do I do?
Yeah.
Just in general?
What things do you do?
That's, how do I make this answer not very long? There's a lot you can do. And I say you, me, us, we. I think anytime there's some rough time going on or a problem, it might not always seem this way, but it always stems from somewhere inside, or at least something external that happens, and the way that you react is still happening inside, so that's no excuse. And it really is just take the time and slow down and turn the TV off and really try and figure out what's going on. There's so many distractions everywhere. And I would theorize that a lot of the distractions are there on purpose. You know, if everyone just learned how to heal themselves and learn that all it takes is to sit down for a couple minutes and really focus on yourself, a lot of companies would be losing money, I'll just say that. So when you're having a problem, try to do everything you can to not blame others, or blame anyone really. It's just, don't judge it. Just try and feel what you're feeling and know that that's okay, and then figure out where you can go from there. But again, essentially it's up to you. So I can't rely on anything else but myself to get myself through hard times. And I suggest the same for everybody.
What's going on in LA? Come on, girl. Dish about work or boys or whatever.
Excuse me. That's funny. I think I already answered that question. And maybe there's parts of that question that I don't want to answer.
What is your big ultimate goal in life? Whether it be acting / singing related or a personal goal? Like, the absolute big one.
I just want everyone to be okay. I just want to help everyone and help myself and just I want everyone to realize how connected we all are and that there's a collective consciousness and everyone has responsibility. Every single person has a responsibility to take care of themselves in order to take care of the masses. And I think about that kind of stuff a lot, and I really feel it, and So then it goes into how do I use what I have or what limited power I have in this material world to help with that, and how do I use what I've been given, like talents or just opportunities really, to work towards that. So ultimate goal, I wanna spread joy and love and hope that everybody else can feel that same feeling, because I've felt both in my life, and trust me, the happiness and the joy is much better. And it's not that hard to attain, really, you know, really isn't, once you realize your own potential. So yes, I just want to help everybody realize that everything's okay, and that we create our futures and we create our own reality. So you can't blame anyone but yourself. You really can't. And once that gets through everybody's head, then we'll start living in a much happier universe.
Which Nostalgia Critic review that you've been in do you like the most?
I think I like the Shining episode the best, just for a multitude of reasons. I think it turned out really well. It was fun. I think I mentioned before, it's like it was interesting to play myself. It was kind of nice, and I remember that being one of the times that we all kind of really clicked and started becoming really close, and I think it was just funny. It was funny, and I got to play. It was like a consistent story that got to play out. I got to make fun of somebody. I guess I'm always doing that on those shows, but I really like that one. That's the one. I mean, that's the winner, I guess, because that's the one that first popped into my head. Right now, I'm trying to think through them all, because it really was a while ago, and I have done a lot since then, just personally in life, so it's always fun to get these questions again and have to relive all that. Get to relive all that. The Shining.
When did you decide you were too old to live with your parents?
It's not really... When did I decide that I was too old? I think what just happened is you naturally just leave when it's time to leave, unless you're holding on to something, unless you're holding yourself back. I left home when I was 18 or 19, just right after high school, really. But then there's been a point where I went home and I just transitioned, living at home for a while again. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with saving up money, especially if you're trying to pay off crazy, crazy debts that you've somehow acquired, you know. In that case, it's smart. But then there's a fine line of just being afraid to let go and move on. So realize what that one is and then decide for yourself.
How does it feel to have your own WikiFeet page?
Good. It's so funny because, like, usually people get famous and then have, like, weird fetish pages about them, but I kind of just, like, got one right out of the gate, so, it's the last time I ever post pictures of my feet. I don't know. Why am I still going into this question, WikiFeet? For those of you who don't know, there's a page dedicated to feet. I'm on it, and what are you gonna do?
If you could convince Doug to review a movie you liked, what would it be?
I would want him to review something that I could defend in a way, I think. Look at me creating a scenario to where I gotta go back and be in. And like I know, because we did the Lord of the Rings series or whatever that one time, and there were so many things that he was saying, and the whole time I was like, yeah, but no, or like this, and so I think that would be fun. But if I wasn't there and I wanted to review something, I can't answer that. I can't even like think of movies. This is my database is empty.
How's LA?
LA is great, everybody. Thank you for asking. That's so nice. It's different, but it's something that I'm used to, because again, I grew up around this area. I'm from here. And so just the culture and everything. It's not a shock. It's almost just like going back home. But now I realize the big differences between like different cities. Not that I've been in that many, but just from Chicago to LA, there's a big difference.
Land any new acting roles? And what do you do for a job?
I did the commercial. I've done a few smaller projects, done some things with some friends. What was the question?
Landon, any new acting roles, and what do you do for a job?
Oh, what do I do for a job? I have a day job. I work as a barista, or kind of in a restaurant type situation. I don't know, it's ever changing. I never really stick with those much.
Are you going to ever go back or guest star on the Nostalgia Critic?
I hope so. If he flies me out there. Yeah, I want to. I already did that one cameo, which was pretty easy. I just filmed it in my room one afternoon. But yeah, I would love to go back at some point, because that means that, one, I get to see all my friends from there, and two, I get to see Chicago again, and that'd be cool. And Tamara, as you guys might know, we are really close friends, and we haven't seen each other in a really long time. But so yeah, I mean, absolutely. Just, it's not up to me, so. But my answer will always be yes.